Hi everyone, my name is Mark. I am the sound tech for Real Connection Church as well as the video editor that uploads the video sermons to the church YouTube page. The reason why I'm stepping in before the sermon starts is because I just want to let everyone know that we had a live stream this past Sunday on March 22nd on the YouTube channel. And first of all, I just want to say thank you for everyone that joined and watched. I know there was some technical issues in the beginning, but right towards the end of the live stream, we had a major problem. When I went to end the live stream, I didn't end it correctly. We are using a program that links up to the YouTube channel to live stream. When I ended it, I ended the live stream on YouTube instead of the software. And so what ended up happening is that it ended up deleting the video of the live stream. Fortunately, though, I had a backup. During the service, I was recording the sermon on my camera as the live service was going on. So what you guys are going to be getting right now is the sermon part of that live stream, not the worship part, due to YouTube's copyright system. Be aware though that we are aware of what happened so that next Sunday, when we do go live, we know what to do and how to end the live stream. So there are some things that which we are working out and improving on. This is the first time we've actually done an entire live service on the YouTube channel compared to Facebook. So again, thank you for those that joined and watched. And yeah, we'll see you next Sunday live at Real Connection Church. And here's Pastor Rodrigo.
Let's continue with the worship service. I just want to send our love and regard to the Suarez Gonzalez family. They lost their grandma yesterday in Venezuela. Quiero enviar nuestro amor y apoyo a la familia Suárez González por la pérdida de su abuelita el día de ayer. Quiero decirles que si usted está siguiendo esta transmisión, por favor envíe su comentario o en un texto al 815-762-5190, si no en el Facebook o en el, puede hacerlo saber. If you are following this this presentation, please send your comments in the Facebook page or in 815-762-5190. Today, I just want to talk about cultivating a strong, healthy faith in Christ. Cultivando una fe saludable y fuerte en el Señor Jesús. Y es que una fe saludable es aquella que se nutre de las promesas y del cuidado de Dios. A healthy faith is one that is nourished by God's promises and care. We've been living in God's promises all the time. If we knew the scripture, si conocemos las escrituras, sabemos que está llena de promesas de Dios. Quisiera resaltar un par de ellas. If we knew the scripture, we know that it's full of promises about God to his people. And I want to highlight a couple of them. Psalms 125:1 says, "Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot move but stand forever." Los que confían en el Señor están seguros como el monte de Sion. No serán vencidos, sino que permanecerán para siempre. Another scripture that we can find and we can help in our faith. Otro versículo bíblico que nos puede ayudar en nuestra fe es Jeremías capítulo 17 versículos 7 y 8. Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 7 and 8 can reaffirm our faith in the Lord. It said, "God will come to the man who trusts in the Lord and who hopes in the Lord. He will be like a tree planted by the water to send out its root by the river. It will not be afraid when the heat comes, but its leaf will be green forever. It will not be troubled in a dry year or stop giving fruit. Pero benditos son los que confían en el Señor y han hecho que el Señor sea su esperanza y su confianza. Son como árboles plantados junto a la ribera de un río con raíces que se hunden en las aguas. A esos árboles no les afecta el calor, ni temen los largos meses de sequía, y sus hojas siempre verdes y nunca dejan de producir fruto. Those beautiful and inspirational Bible verses will remind in just nine sentences if we don't believe in them, if we don't include those in our faith, in our every daily life. Estos lindos versículos bíblicos quedarán ahí solamente en lindas frases si no las creemos y las incluimos en nuestra vida diaria. Nowadays are difficult days. In a difficult days like crisis today, we're experiencing sometimes that our faith is failing. Even for those who have strong faith, sometimes their faith is shaking by crisis times. En momentos de crisis como estos, algunos experimentan que su fe se vuelve débil y también se tambalea. Así que hoy estamos hablando de una fe saludable y fuerte. That's why today we are talking about a healthy, strong faith. And just like I just said, even people of God, sometimes their faith is strong. And we find in 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 1 to 3, one of those examples. Aún aquellos que tienen una fe fuerte y saludable en el Señor, muchas veces su fe se siente tambaleante. Y encontramos un ejemplo de ellos en 1 Reyes, capítulo 19, del 1 al 3. In this portion of the scripture, we can find Elijah, one of the biggest prophets of the Bible. Encontramos a Elías, uno de los profetas más grandes que hemos visto en la Biblia, right after that he kills 400 false prophets, he now is running, scared, hiding in a cave. Ahora lo encontramos después de haber matado a 400 profetas falsos del dios Baal. Él está corriendo, está huyendo y escondido en una cueva. And this is what he said. Ahab told to Jezebel all that Elijah has done. He told her how Elijah had killed with the sword all the men who spoke for Baal. Then Jezebel sent news to Elijah saying, "So may the gods do me and even more if I do not make your life as the life of the one then by this time tomorrow." Elijah was afraid and he get up and rise from his and run from his life. When he comes to Beersheba of Judah, he left his servant there, but he himself traveled to a day into the desert. And he came and sat down under the juniper tree. There he asked that he might die, saying, "It is enough now, O Lord, take my life, for I am not better than my father's." Aquí podemos ver a Elías corriendo, temiendo por su vida, escondiéndose en una cueva y diciéndole al Señor, "Basta ya, Señor, quítame la vida porque no soy mejor que mis antepasados que ya murieron." There is some ways that we can cultivate our faith. There is a way that we can make our faith strong. And instead of running away from being filled with fear, just like Elijah did, we should take refuge in the Lord and His arm, and we are sure. En lugar de huir y estar llenos de temor como Elías, debemos refugiarnos en los brazos del Señor. Ahí estaremos seguros. In the arm of the Lord, we can feel safe. We can feel that He is protecting us. This is one way that we can cultivate our faith, going to the right place, going to the right person. The only one who can save us, the only one who can protect us at this moment is the Lord. El único que nos puede proteger, el único que nos puede hacer estar seguros es el Señor. Yes, we're living in a community who is attacking by this virus now. And this is a serious matter. Just in Italy, they surpassed the 4,000 people dead. And just imagine all at home around the world. Even yesterday was the first official people with this virus here in DeKalb County. Así que la amenaza que tenemos es una amenaza seria. Es una amenaza cierta. Solo en Italia han muerto más de 4,000 personas. Ahora usted suma el número alrededor del mundo y ayer se comprobó el primer caso aquí en nuestra comunidad, en el condado de DeKalb. But when that happened, when situations like this happen, who make us be afraid, who make us to be scared, is where we can go and run to the Lord. En momentos como estos, en los que estamos asustados y quizás con temor, es cuando nosotros debemos de ir al Señor. Psalm 56:3 said this, when I am afraid, I will trust in you, Lord. Cuando estoy asustado, cuando tengo miedo, en ti pondré mi confianza. That's why the big question, la gran pregunta today, the big question today is, where is your trust at this moment? ¿Dónde está tu fe en este momento, tu confianza? I just want to remind you what the Bible says. Quiero recordarte lo que la Biblia dice en el Salmo 91:1-3. Psalms 91:1-3 said this. He who lives in the safe place of the Most High will be in the shadow of the All-Powerful. I will say to the Lord, you are my safe and strong place, my God in whom I trust. For it is He who takes away from the trap and from the killing sickness. Los que viven al amparo del Altísimo encontrarán descanso a la sombra del Todopoderoso. Declaro lo siguiente acerca del Señor. Solo Él es mi refugio, mi lugar seguro. Él es mi Dios. En Él yo confío. Te rescatará de todas las trampas y te protegerá de enfermedades mortales. I think que there is no better Bible verse who can ensure us that we'll be protected by the Lord than this one. Look, I just want to reread the number 3. For is He who takes you away from the trap and from the killing sickness. No hay un versículo más firme y más seguro que este que nos recuerda lo que el Señor hace por su gente. Te rescatará de toda trampa y te protegerá de enfermedades mortales. I will say, gloria a Dios, aleluya. Yo diría, gloria al Señor, aleluya, por estas promesas, for these promises that the Lord has made for us, His people. Esas son las promesas que Dios ha hecho para nosotros, su gente. But also came to us the question, how can I maintain my faith always in the highest peak? Entonces viene la pregunta, ¿cómo podemos mantener nuestra fe en el pico más alto? And then is the Lord is given always, He gives us what we need to keep our lives safe and safe. Dios siempre nos da lo que nosotros necesitamos para estar seguros y a salvos. Y es que tenemos la ventaja de la convivencia de la familia de la fe. And this is one of those things that God is giving to us in order to be in the highest point in our faith. We need to take advantage of the community of faith. We are not alone. I would like you to say there where you are in your home now that you can say, we are not alone. Dígalo, yo no estoy solo. Esa es una de las cosas que Dios nos ha dado y es la comunidad de la fe. Even though we are through the internet, even though we don't have a personal contact, we are still united in the name of the Lord. Aun cuando no estemos teniendo un contacto físico, nosotros estamos unidos en el Señor. Estamos unidos en una fe, en un solo Señor, en un solo bautismo y en sus promesas. We are united with Him in one faith, in one Lord, in one baptism, in His promises. We are not alone. We have the church, which is the body of Christ, who we all together, we can overcome this situation. Nosotros somos el cuerpo de Cristo, la iglesia, y todos juntos vamos a superar esta situación. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11 said this, so comfort each other and make each other strong as you are already doing. You are already doing by you being connected today, by you calling your friend, your loved one, by phone, by internet, whatever media you use to contact your friend and keep them strong and closer, you are doing what the Lord is saying. Primera Tesalonicenses dice, por eso anímense y edifíquense unos a otros, todo tal como vienen haciendo. Cuando usted se conecta por medio de la internet, cuando usted habla con sus amigos por medio del Facebook, cuando usted los llama por teléfono y les hace saber su amor y el amor que el Señor tiene por ellos, usted está haciendo lo correcto. Hebreos 10, 23 al 25 dice esto. Mantengámonos firmes sin titubear en la esperanza que afirmamos, porque se puede confiar en que Dios cumplirá su promesa. Pensemos en maneras de motivarnos unos a otros a realizar actos de amor y buenas acciones. Hebrews chapter 10, 23-25 says, let us hold on the hope that we say that we have and not be changed. We can trust God that will do what His promises. Let us help each other to love others and to do good. This is the time when you can show the love of God, helping your brother and your sister. When you call them, when you connected with your friends and your family, besides that you can ask, how are you? You can ask the next question, what can I do for you? This is the way that we as a believer, that we as a Christian, we can show the love of the Lord in this heart moment. Así que, cuando usted llame a su hermano, a su hermana, a su familia y amigos, además de decirle, ¿cómo estás?, deberías de añadir la pregunta, ¿qué puedo hacer por ti? Haciendo esto, estamos mostrando el amor práctico del Señor hacia los demás. Esa es otra manera de cultivar nuestra fe saludable y fuerte en el Señor. This is another way to cultivate our faith and keep it healthy and strong. Hebrews chapter 10, 25 continues saying this. Let us not stay away from church meetings. Some people are doing this all the time. Comfort each other as you see that the day of His return coming near. And I will see Jesus coming soon. No dejemos de congregarnos como hacen algunos, sino animémonos unos a otros, sobre todo ahora que el día del regreso del Señor se acerca. Jesus is coming, el Señor viene pronto. But you know, this is a great opportunity, even that you don't have to come here to our building. This is the way that we can continue being connected. Right now, in my mind, I have different images. I see your family sitting in the living room watching this service and a bigger screen in your TV. Some of you may be in your bed with your cell phone or your tablet watching this service. But wherever you are and wherever you are doing, the good thing is that you are connected with your friends, with your brothers in Christ, people from real connections and all around the world. Cuando yo estoy aquí predicando, me estoy imaginando a mis familias en Cristo, sentados en su sala, viendo este servicio en un televisor grande, o acostados tal vez en su cama, en su tablet o en su cell phone, pero todos conectados, unidos en una reunión de iglesia. Y es aquí entonces cuando el Señor está en medio de nosotros. Porque cuando hay dos o tres reunidos en su nombre, Él está en medio de ellos. Because wherever two or more are gathered together in the name of the Lord, the presence of the Most Almighty is there. And I know you're saying hallelujah in your house. Gloria a Dios. Let's not stay away from church meeting. And talking about church meeting, that's very easy. You are watching this in YouTube. You just subscribe there and hit the bell. And then you have notification when we, Real Connection, will be in the air with the new videos and new Bible studies. And every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock, we will have prayer meetings through YouTube and Facebook. You just have to send your prayer request to me, and we will pray for you. And Friday at 7 o'clock, we will do the same thing in Espanol. You just go to youtube.com, subscribe, hit the bell, and you will receive the notification. También haremos esto en Espanol. Tendremos oración el día viernes a las 7 de la noche por YouTube o Facebook. Usted solamente conéctese, envíe sus peticiones de oración, y estaremos orando por usted. But continue with this. When our faith gets weak, there is fear came and is seen. And my question for you today is, what is your biggest fear? Cuando situaciones como estas empiezan a resurgir, mi pregunta es, ¿cuál es tu mayor temor? ¿Perder el empleo? ¿No tener suficiente dinero para cuidar de tu familia? ¿Que tú o un ser querido se enferme? ¿Losing a job? ¿No having enough money to take care of your family? ¿You or any of your loved ones get sick? ¿Is those your biggest fear? Those are valuable fear. Son temores válidos. I, as a father, I can be worried if one of my kids gets sick or I get sick. I believe you do the same. Yo como papá me voy a preocupar si uno de mis hijos o mi esposa o yo mismo me enfermo. Claro que sí. Es natural. It's natural to fear in those times. But I want to remind you, where is our trust? Where we put our trust. Quiero recordarte dónde nuestra confianza está puesta. Nuestra fe, our faith is in the Shaddai, the Almighty, in Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides. Jehovah Rapha, the healer, and Jehovah Shalom, the God of peace. That is where we put our trust. Hemos puesto nuestra fe y nuestra confianza en el Shaddai, en el Dios Todopoderoso, en Jehová Jireh, el Dios que todo provee, Jehová Rafa, el Dios que sana, Jehová Shalom, el Dios de nuestra paz. Yes, there is a difficult times today. But you know, difficult times always not stay forever. Nothing stays forever. In Spanish, there is a saying who said, no hay mal que dure 100 años, ni cuerpo que lo resista. I don't know what will be this translating in English, but that will be, there is no bad days that can live longer than 100 years and body that resists. Something like that. But, you know, Apostle Paul, he wrote to the Corinthians church. They have a difficult times at that time when he wrote this letter. But Paul says to the Corinthians, in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, 17, said this, "For our trouble, light and momentary, is producing for us an eternal weight of glory for beyond and all compassions. As we look not on what can be seen, but what can not be seen. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal. Pues nuestras dificultades actuales son pequeñas y no durarán mucho tiempo. Sin embargo, nos producen una gloria que durará para siempre y que es de mucho más peso que las dificultades. Así que no miremos las dificultades que ahora vemos. En cambio, fijemos nuestra vista en las cosas que no pueden verse. Pues las cosas que ahora podemos ver pronto se habrán ido, pero las cosas que no podemos ver permanecen para siempre." Things that we can see. You can see the store empty. You go to the grocery store and you don't see anything there. You go and walk to the street, you don't see people walking up there. Those are things that you can see. But things that you cannot see is the love of your family, the love that God has for you, the faith and the trust that you can put in the Lord, and those are still forever. Y cosas que usted puede ver son las tiendas vacías, gente que no está caminando afuera, personas asustadas, pero lo que usted no puede ver es el amor de su familia, el amor de Dios, y esas cosas permanecen para siempre. Así que pongamos nuestra confianza en el Señor. Let's trust in the Lord. That will be the moonstreet of our faith. That will be the way that we can feed our faith. Trusting in the Lord. Esa es la forma en que nosotros podemos alimentar nuestra fe. And I want to be finished with this Bible verse. Joshua chapter 1, verse 9. And this is what the Lord says, not only to Moses, but also he replied and said the same thing to Joshua. And he's telling us today the same thing. Joshua chapter 1, 9 says, "This is my command. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Don't be afraid. Don't run like Eliah. Stay firm. Raise your eyes to the Almighty. And ask Him to open your eyes and you can see His hands over you, keeping you safe. Este es el momento en que debemos de levantar nuestra vista al cielo y pedirle al Señor que abra nuestros ojos y ver sus manos cubriéndonos y protegiéndonos hoy. Because the Bible says, el Señor tu Dios está contigo donde quiera que vayas. The Bible says that your God is with you wherever you go. And Psalm 23 says, even if you go to the valley of death, aun cuando vayas por el valle de la muerte, yo estaré contigo. I be with you. I will be your support. I will helping you to go through this. That's what the Lord says. Yo te voy a ayudar a pasar sobre esto. Es lo que dice el Señor. I will say, gloria a Dios. I will say, Lord, thank you for your promises, because that helped me to grow in my faith. And that is the what I need in these moments of hard times. You know, the government always said, you know, when we have crisis, this is what you have to have. You have to have one safe kit. You know, you have to have medicine. You have to have a flashlight. You have to have a battery radio and all have the kind food. And you have to be in shelter. And you will be safe. I will say, this is what we need. We need to trust in the Lord. We need to believe in His promises. And yes, we can do what the government says because it's wise. And the Lord said that we need to be wise. And the wisdom is in the multitude of counselors. And that's why the government is working, trying to give the best advices and help us through as a community to get over this. But beside the follow the recommendation of the government, put your trust in the Lord. Cierto, tenemos que ser sabios y seguir los consejos que el gobierno nos da, porque el gobierno está haciendo todo lo posible para encontrar la solución a esta crisis. Así que como ciudadanos responsables seguimos sus directrices, pero también ponemos nuestra confianza en el Señor. Amén. Our worship team is going to come back and sing one of those songs that we sing before, and then we go back and give the final blessing, the benediction. El grupo va a cantar una canción más, y entonces regresamos con la bendición final. We are not done yet. Don't go away. Don't go and prepare your sandwiches. Stay there and you are where you are and continue singing and worship the Lord. If you are home singing with us this song, because we have 10,000 reasons to sing to the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let's sing all together, right there in your couch, in the living room, in the kitchen, wherever you are.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, my soul, I'll worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning, it's time to sing your song again. Maybe singing when the evening comes. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, bless Him, His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Heart is kind, for all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Seems like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name.
And on that day when my strength is failed, the end draws.
thousand years and ten forevermore. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Your holy name. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship Your holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Worship Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name.
Glory be to God. Que la gloria sea para el Señor. I want to finish with this final benediction. Esta bendición final. It's come from 1 Timothy chapter 4, 22. Says, may the Lord be with your spirit, and may His grace be with all of you. Que el Señor esté con tu espíritu, y que su gracia sea con todos. Que Dios te bendiga. God bless you. If you were blessed by this service today, if you don't know if your brother or sister watch it, this is recorded on YouTube. You can send your link to your family and your friends, and they will can watch it later today. Some people is asking me how they can continue doing the tithe and offering. I just want to explain to you how you may do this. For those who call, for those who send a message and emails asking how they can tithe and offering to the church, because the church continue with we need to continue paying our bills and everything. You can send it to Real Connection Church, and our address is 1115 South Malta Road in DeKalb, Illinois. If you are a member of the church, you have the address in our bulletins, and also you can call me anytime, 815-762-5190. Algunos me han estado preguntando, enviando textos, preguntando cómo pueden ofrendar y diezmar. Usted puede seguir haciéndolo por medio de enviar su cheque a la dirección de la iglesia. Es 1115 South Malta Road, aquí en DeKalb, Illinois, 60115, la iglesia de Real Connecting Church. Oye, me puede llamar para pedirme mejores instrucciones. Así que Dios los bendiga, que el Señor esté con tu espíritu, y que su gracia sea con todos ustedes. May the Lord be with your spirit, and may His grace be with all of you. See you next Tuesday at 7 in our prayer meeting. If you cannot make it Tuesday, you can make it Friday, 7 o'clock, for a prayer meeting. Nos vemos el próximo martes o el viernes a las 7 de la noche para nuestro estudio bíblico y oración. Dios les bendiga. God bless you.